Okay, now each week or every couple of weeks, I'm going to select, I say every couple of weeks because I don't have a producer for this show. I'm the one that's driving it. So we'll see how much time I get during the week. Anyway, you don't need to know that. Each week, every couple of weeks, whatever it is, I'm going to select an artist or group that have been influential to either me or the music of world, or the world of music, music of the world, either me or the world of music. And it's sort of like their music spliced together with some interviews that they've done. So tonight I'm paying tribute to Queen. Little bit of a backstory. Queen were an English rock band who were formed in London in 1970 following the demise of the band Smile. Queen consisted of vocalist Freddie Mercury, guitarist Brian May, bassist John Deacon, and drummer Roger Taylor. The band became popular with audiences via their hit song, live performances, and originality and showmanship. Their 1985 Live Aid performance was voted the best live rock performance of all time in an industry poll. Queen enjoyed success in the UK in the early to mid-1970s with the albums Queen and Queen 2, but it was with the release of Sheer Heart Attack in 1974 and A Night at the Opera the following year that the band gained international success. They have released 15 studio albums, 5 live albums, and numerous compilation albums. Since Mercury's death in 1991 and Deacon's retirement, May and Taylor have performed infrequently together at special events and programmes as members of other ensembles. Between 2004 to 2009, the duo collaborated with Paul Rogers under the title Queen and Paul Rogers. So here we go. Tonight's tribute to music, The Late Show's tribute to the music.
Hello, my name is Freddie Mercury.
The way I look at myself, if I ever do, is as I'm a man of extremes. If I didn't do this, I don't have anything to do, you know. I can't cook. I'm not very good at being a housewife.
Empty spaces, what are we living for? Abandoned places.
I'm very disorganized at times, I'm organized at times, and I'm just me.
I can't relax in bed all day and just do nothing. I think it's a waste of time. I hardly read books, you know, that's a waste of time. People are going to kill me for this. I have to be doing something every day. I want to earn my keep. I don't wake up every morning and say, oh, look, have I dried up, you know. He's looking after me.
I don't give a shit what people say about me.
And I hate writing lyrics anyway, because I'm not a poet. I wish somebody else could do it. Mind you, but I'm not like that. I like to do it all myself anyway. I'm a greedy bitch.
You don't fool me. You don't fool me. You don't fool me, 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 you don't fool me.
I hate doing the same things again. I like to see what's happening now and try and sort of incorporate all those kind of forms into Queen. We all have our ups and downs and we all have our limitations. And we all know that there are certain things you can't do. But I mean, I don't want some asshole critic to tell me that.
And I want to do it my way, to sound like Frank Sinatra.
I think every character is made up of a load of ingredients. And I just think I have a very soft side and a very hard side. On stage, I'm very strong. Nobody can get. That's when I'm very powerful. But when I'm off stage, I can be very soft. So if the right person gets me, they'll find me that I'm very vulnerable and I can be a real baby. I'm not worried about sort of making mistakes and things like that. I think I'm too old for that.
I don't regret any of the things I did. I mean, what did you look like 10 years ago?
I think in the end, being natural and being actually genuine is what wins. I hope that comes out in my songs. think we know each other quite instinctively now after all these years. And there wasn't anything like, oh, I want to go and further my career without you. It wasn't that sort of thing. It's just something that...
space to do something else.
Yeah, and I mean, we've been together now 18 years, I would say. 17 or whatever.
Oh,
I
my think, God!
I really think that if egos had sort of... if egos came into it, they would have done that a long time ago, and we would have gone our separate ways and all that. I think it's just, after a while, we get bored with each other, and then sort of we need
a bit of space.
We need a bit of space.
I think we learn to give each other our space, yeah. which keeps the balance of the band, because it's very hard to stay together all that time, really. In fact, that's the number one trick, in a way. It's the secret. If you do stay together and you can still use each other's talents, but at the same time give each other some space to be individuals, I think that's the secret.
Every drop of rain that falls in Sahara Desert says it all, it's a miracle. All God's creations, great and small, the Golden Gate and the Taj Mahal, that's a miracle.
When we were actually doing the sort of magic tour, I mean, I had no inclination that I was going to do a solo sort of project with Montserrat. But I did have in the back of my mind that I wanted to do something by myself. And I think so did the other lads.
And we'd had so many years, you know.
Yes, and so it was just a sort of breather.
Doing the same things, yeah.
It was just a breather. And to do some things that we wanted to do without each other. But it wasn't a split.
Barcelona! It was the first time that we met. Barcelona! How can I forget the moment that you stepped into the room? You took my breath away. Barcelona!
This last couple of weeks, I have been working with this amazing woman. She's a big operatic star. Her name is Montserrat Caballé. She comes from Barcelona. And she just called up a few weeks ago and said she'd like to sing with me. So, of course, I fell flat on the floor. You know, I thought, my God. But I've loved her, you know, for years. And I think it worked when I went to Barcelona recently. I did a TV show and they asked me, you know, and I said, well, you know, she's the best singer in the world. And, I'd love to be able to sing with her. So she must have read, she must have seen it. And so she called up the office and said she'd like to do things. So, last night, I mean, she sang one of my songs at the Royal Opera House. So it's amazing. I mean, now I'm going to opera, you know, forget rock and roll.
Is this a new experience, an exciting experience?
Absolutely, it's such a challenge, actually. It's, that's going to be great, because I've never sort of thought of writing songs in that way. Now, she said she wants to do duets with me. I have to sort of think in a totally different way. And actually, I'm sure the opera critics would, you know, slam it and everything. But I mean, this is something that, it's a good challenge this time in life, you know.